Chris Haggis with Low and Mean, and today I want to show you how to install a Platinum Air Ride suspension into this Victory Highball. Now, I really like these kits because it gives you the best of both worlds. You not only get an amazing ride compared to the stock shock, but you get to drop the motorcycle and look, I don't know, low and mean. Let me show you how to install this kit. It is actually really easy.
Follow us on Facebook at Victory Products by Low and Mean.
Here's a look at the kit you'll get from Platinum Air Suspension. You've got some great detailed instructions with pictures. This is the shock itself. Pretty simple stuff. This is where it gets a little tricky. This hose here comes in one long reel. I actually already cut it. And so the one going to the compressor, which is here, is 19 inches. This is the one going to the bottom of the shock, which we cut to 13 inches at the bottom of the shock here. And then the top of the shock, which will be 4 inches. So this is your bleed feed control valve. It's quite a bit of wiring in here. Don't be intimidated. It's really basic stuff. It's really pretty much a plug and play situation. This goes to your battery, so you have a relay switch. And then these here are the actual compression and rebound switches that we're going to mount on the motorcycle. We'll get to that in a little bit. Here's our compressor and then a nice bracket that holds it to the bottom of the bike. So it looks really OEM and fits the motorcycle well. And that's a look at what you should get from Platinum. Hey guys, I want you to understand that this motorcycle is not right off the showroom floor. It is a customer's bike, so a few things have been changed around. So when I start getting into this motorcycle, not everything's in the same place or location of what you have on your bike. Just take this as a reference. So what I'm going to do is basically I'm going to be pulling off seats. You know, I already took out the bolts and stuff to make it easier for us. Take off the side covers, and we're going to get into removing the stock shock. So just so you guys know, this is not bolted on. It's sort of a press, sort of rubber plug kind of thing. Three spots here. So it just pulls right off. Real simple. If you haven't done it before, it's nothing to worry about. We'll also need to remove this fuse box assembly. So removing these 10 millimeter bolts, we'll pull this off so we can get to the shock bolts. Okay, once we have this down and out of the way, we can get to this upper shock bolt here. Before you start getting into removing the components that actually connect the swing arm to the frame, it's really important that you make sure that you have the bike stable, it's strapped down, take the tension off of the rear tire so when you do remove the shock that nothing's binding and or it doesn't collapse or anything. So definitely know your abilities and make sure you do things safely. I'm also going to go to the other side and disconnect the battery so there's no power to the motorcycle. I don't arc anything. And again, safety first, right? So I want you guys to notice that my bolt slides in and out real easy right now. The shock's in it, wheels are on, you know, but I've just taken the pressure off of the shock right now. So you know you have it stable when this bolt slides in and out real easy. So it's a good little trick, but you definitely want to make sure that there's no tension on this bolt before you start to remove everything. So in order to remove the stock shock, you're going to have to remove this bolt and that bolt there. This bolt here is going to drop down the dog bones to the swing arm, and that one there is holding on the bottom of the shock. Once I remove those, the shock should slide right out this direction. Hey guys. Okay, there's a collar right here. Do not use your finger to push this out. Get a screwdriver. Push it out so you don't stick your finger in this hole that you might lose a finger. See that? Now you got a shock coming right out at you. Alright guys, this is kind of the point where you want to install the billet shock into the motorcycle. I've kind of kept the saran wrap on to this up to this point. Like I want to remove it now just to get it in there, but obviously it's there to protect the shock so you don't scratch it. It's a beautiful piece, but this is kind of the point of no return. So let's I'm going to peel this off. All right, there we are. Here's the shock reservoir. I went ahead and connected the bottom hose. This was the 13-inch line that we had cut. This is just suggested. You guys do it however you want, but this is our length. So it's pretty simple to carefully squeeze this in. I'm going to go for the top bolt. And so the nut's still there for this top bolt. It's kind of resting on wire harnesses and a bracket, and it's pretty simple. I'm using my screwdriver to kind of just line it up. And then I'm using the screwdriver to kind of pinch it up against the frame so I can tighten it down. So. All right, so the Platinum Air Ride Kit does come with a really nice chrome-plated bolt. So I'm going to use this down at the bottom here. Pretty simple stuff. Put it on. Tighten it down. So here's the bleed feed control valve. Now I've labeled it. Blue is compressor, red is top, yellow is bottom. All this is in the instructions that you get in the kit. So this control unit is gonna sneak into right in front of the rear fender, but inside the frame area. So obviously with a lot of this kind of out of the way, and again, you know, this could be a little bit different than your motorcycle, but this is our suggested location. So I'm going to kind of sneak this thing in there and then run the wire harness so it comes up. So yeah, just hopefully this video helps you a little bit with your installation. I've got these hoses connected and I'm gonna fish down the one. This is the compressor, so I'm gonna push it down to the bottom of the bike, like so. I got the one from the bottom of the shock right there, which I can plug into this guy right now. Here's the wire harness, so I'm going to feed this up into the bike, just like that, and I'll just let it hang over the other side. And we'll sneak this guy in. Just like so. Can I see that? Right there. There we go. So originally I have a 4-inch hose, and I had the inlet valve on the other side, which means the shock was turned around. It doesn't really matter which way you have the shock, but I made a mistake, didn't put the shock in the same way, but it's no big deal. So I have some extra hose from the kit. They send one long and a really cool little cutter. It's really simple. So I'm going to line up what I need here, which looks to be about 5 or 6 inches, about in there. Put it in. Make sure I cut it really clean. It's not all jaggedy. Now push it into the top of the shock here. Push it really good and then pull it out. Make sure it's locked in, and then over to the control valve. They're just push locks, real simple stuff here. You can hear it kind of pop in, and I'll pull it out, make sure it's stuck, and there you go. It's really as simple as that. So I'll push that down and I'll get this bracket and fuse box back up into place, and I'm on to the next step. All right, so here we are to the stage of the wire harness. This can be intimidating if you haven't done it before. But the diagram here is super helpful, so just follow this. It tells you everything you want to know. So I'm going to set this down. I've done it a couple times. So really what we have here is this is our relay here. So this basically goes to the battery. You know, we have some connections here that you definitely want to cover up with some hose or, you know, just end caps. But we'll fish this thing down towards the battery, underneath the seat rail there, if I can. There we go. So we'll let that just kind of chill right there. And here is our actual switches, which we're gonna mount to the front of the bike. So what I'll do is I'm just gonna route them through the frame here, behind the cylinder. So pull these out, and we're gonna put these up into the side cover there, the little cheese wedge. And you'll see this here. This is for the optional remote, which is really cool. You got a remote you can switch from 50 feet away to kind of activate the air ride system. The simple plug, this is pretty important here. You want to make sure that these two arrows line up. This snugs down nice and tight. You don't have anything not lined up properly, the system's not going to work right. So pretty basic. We have our ground wire to the battery, bam. And then the last one is to power up the air compressor. So here's the line here. So if your air compressor does not have the other male end of this female plug, you want to make sure it does. So I'm going to route this down through the bike towards where the air compressor is going to mount, right down there. So once I get kind of the wires towards the direction that they go, I'll sort of wrap everything up, zip tie it, make sure it's secure underneath the seat, and we're on to the next step. Here is the compressor bracket and the compressor. So if this does not come installed, you will want to install it. You'll see that these long two bolts that go all the way through hold it on one side, and then you have the three bolts along with the seal plate in there. So just to give you a look of how it should be mounted. It is a tight fit, but it does fit. So real simple. You know, you have a ground and a power, and then you have your airline. Now at the bottom of the bike, it might confuse you, but it looks like there's two lines here. The one up higher is actually a vent for the something in the motor. I'm not exactly sure. This is the one we ran that came from the bleed feed controls valve. So I'm gonna, again, it's a press lock, push in, pull out, locked into place. So I got that, so I'm gonna rest that to the side. So this mounts on two points. We have a large Allen bolt there, which is a 8mm Allen. And then we have a little 10mm guy there. So the little 10mm is going to be the ground. So we'll want to get those to kind of go together. So slowly kind of twist this thing around. You'll see that we have sort of a kind of a OEM appeal to the bike there. So pretty simple stuff. And don't forget, we have, here's our male little plug that's gonna go up to the other wire that comes from the bleed feed control valve. So that's pretty much what you're up against to install this compressor. So I'm gonna start taking out the bolts and getting this thing to fit into place. All right, so there it is. It's pretty simple, two bolts, and this thing is really strong. So I got, again, my ground wire on the little 10mm bolt, which you kind of need to get in there like so with a wrench. Got that on. I got my power wire, you can see kind of up here. That's plugged in. My compressor airline is hooked up, so I'm solid down there, ready for the next step. We've decided to put our switches on the cheese wedge. And so to remove this, it's simple, it's just carefully pulling it off. And you have three spots here that click in to the OEM bracket there. Pretty easy. So we also installed two holes here. They're quarter inch holes, so we can put our switches into this cheese wedge. That's what it looks like installed. Again, this is our suggestion. You could put them wherever you feel like it's necessary. I like to keep it on the left side of the bike so you're not using your throttle hand. But regardless, it's really important to make sure that the switches go forward and back. You know, you don't want them going side to side or opposite directions of each other. You want to really make sure that they go forward and back. It's much easier on using them, especially when you're riding. So, simple as that. Just kind of press that back into place, and there we go, nice and hidden away. So the last step really is to go back to your battery and connect all of this. You know, so once you've got everything zip tied up and you got some threat protectors on this, you connect your battery, you're pretty much ready to test out the new AirRide system from Platinum. All right, so we have everything installed, and at this point, really kind of demonstrating the switches and showing you the capabilities of this Platinum AirRide suspension for your Victory motorcycle. So again, the switches are up here on the little cheese wedge. So I'm gonna drop it down. And that thing goes pretty low. So then the switch is here, pull it back, raises it up. So once you have it raised up all the way, you have a rebound switch, which is the inside switch, and you're going to push it forward. And what this does is compresses the motorcycle down, makes the shock a little bit more firm, so you get a firmer ride out of it. Now you can adjust this as you're riding. So if you want a softer ride, you lift it back up for the softer, squishier ride, and then you want it more firm. And you can adjust that rebound however you guys see fit for your roads. Again, the coolest thing about this kit is being able to drop it down.
Low and Mean, the leader in aftermarket bolt-on products for your cruiser. Check out our website for all our products, www.lowandmean.com. Follow us on Facebook at Low and Mean. And please, while you're here, subscribe to the YouTube channel.